Before I start, I just want to show you, you know, I got full screen, VSync is off. Normally I would turn VSync on, but my plasma screen has like, it can refresh as fast as a tube TV. It's got like a 600 hertz refresh rate, so I don't necessarily have to worry about screen tearing. My system specs are custom. I use the autoexec.config file to specify the specs that I want, and it's basically everything is ultra except for anything that has to do with anti-aliasing. I turn those off, and then DirectX is on. And you remember, with the single 465, I got 40 to 45 at 1080 on high. So this is going to be on ultra. See, everything's set to ultra except my post-processing, because all the anti-aliasing is technically considered post-processing. So it says custom because it's used in the file. High res is on. Motion blur is off. I don't really like motion blur that much. So let's go ahead and I'm going to load up the sudden impact level, which is the big airplane crashing into the building, and we'll play it. So I'll be back. Now it's loaded. See, I'm averaging about 70 to 80 just standing here. It'll drop, but everything's ultra except for the anti-aliasing. It drops down to about 50, 48. Flip in the corner. 31, 32. See, so this card is pretty righteous. I'm getting about 50. I'm very happy with 50.
Oversight 67, I have your kill confirmed. Hold station. We're coming in.
You see that? Must have gone down less than a block from where you are.
I'm averaging about 45 to 50 on ultra.
Let's
see what this explosion does. It doesn't go below 40. Uh-oh, came back at me. See, I had 35 there when stuff was real hairy. So, what I might actually do is I might run a benchmark on extreme and maybe turn some anti-aliasing up to maybe 2, because I can notice the jaggies along like the edges here. So if I can bump it up to maybe 2, I can get a little better performance and still on extreme not take such a big performance hit. So I might do that next. But it never really dropped below 40 except for that one time when I was doing that barrel roll. See, now since I turned everything down to 3, it says everything says extreme except my shading and my post-processing both say custom now. So I'm going to go ahead and fire the game up at the same spot, and we'll see what kind of frame rates we can get. Well, as I loaded here, it doesn't say 70, it says 100. So it's already higher. Anti-aliasing looks better.
Bring him down.
Let's see what it was. 70. 50, 45.
Confirmed. Hold station. We're coming in.
Well, see the
Prophet.
Well, talking.
You see that? Must have gone down less than a block from where you are. You do realize what this means, right? This is our chance. This is it. Forget extraction. We have to jump on this. Go get Jasper and Crash. Get them to me here at the lab. This could be our best shot at rolling back the score. Maybe the whole invasion even. But you better make it fast. Bargard's going to have cells swarming all over that crash site. It's nothing flat. Watch your ass, Prophet.
Yeah, it's horrible. Controller. See, it dropped down to 60, so I've gained, 20 frames a second. But I can still, see, I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but that edge anti-aliasing, it works, it looks good up close, but as I back away, you can kind of tell that it's still a little jaggy. So I think it helped a little bit, but instead of averaging 45, I'm hitting 75, so I don't know. I might play around with some of the settings to get somewhere around 50. One of the other things that I did want to note is you see that GPU utilization right there? See how it's not really peaking? It's kind of going up and down and up and down. I think that might actually be symptomatic of a CPU bottleneck. If it's not being pegged at 99%, I don't know. When I was running Combuster, it pegged it, but I think the reason it's dropping down and being underutilized is because it's being held up by the i5 or the i3 Ivy Bridge. But you can see that I still got, 75 frames a second is nothing to shake a hat at. So, for a $100 CPU, it does very well.